Bom dia. Bem-vindo a Rio. It's a pleasure to be here. I spent my evening walking about Rio last night. It's a great city. It took a long time to walk anywhere, though. I think it's a city that could use a little bit of investments. And that is, of course, what we're going to talk about now. How do we make our city great? What kind of investments? I lead our work with cities around the world, which gives me a great chance to explore this, to see these cities. But it also required us to think about what's our role and what are we trying to achieve. So in the next 9 minutes, I'll try to tell you how to make a city great and challenge you for what you can make, how you can make your city great. Now, every city should be at least a good city. We are the species that lives in cities. Cities are us. Cities are our jobs. Cities are our healthcare. Cities are where we live, work, eat, and play. We know all this. Running a city is perhaps the single most complicated thing the human race does. Cities last for thousands of years. Cities are the only evidence that the human race exists from outer space. This is, in fact, who we are. But what makes a great city? That was the question we asked ourselves. When we started this work with cities, we wanted to know what would make us distinctive. Well, this was a tough question because everybody had a different answer. Some people told us that great cities are the ones that respect the environment, that preserve biodiversity, that integrate human activities with nature. Others said, no, you can't have a great city unless you have jobs. Cities are the economic drivers. Cities are where we work. Cities are how we create wealth as a human race. And yet others said, none of that matters if we can't enjoy it. All of this theoretical wealth doesn't matter unless I, the individual citizen, has access to education, to health, to security. And as we looked at all of this, we came to one conclusion, that these things are related to each other. It is impossible to be a great economic city if you have crime in the streets and if you've despoiled your environment. If you have a failing economy, you cannot spend money on the police force or cleaning up the rivers. There is a high correlation between economic, social, and environmental development, and a great city is great on all three dimensions. It is a failure to try to separate these. You must think of them together. That was the first thing we found. The second thing we found is that actually, people are not so interested in becoming something else. Shanghai doesn't want to become London. New York doesn't want to become Chicago. Rio doesn't want to become Tokyo. We want to become a better Rio. Shanghai wants to be a better Shanghai. Greatness is not about an absolute level, it's about a performance, an improvement, a trajectory, a pursuit. So here we have Dubai, cities that have come out of the ground, literally, in the last 30 years. Greatness is a pursuit, a trajectory, and we are in the age of cities. 30 years ago, we had maybe 10 cities the size of New York City. 100 years ago, we had two. 100 years from now, we will have hundreds. We will have hundreds of cities the size of New York City. This is who we are. This is what we have to do. So, what makes a city great? How do you get there? There are many paths, but we did find three things that make a difference. What we've called smart growth. Everybody has a different definition. Doing more with less, and winning support for change. A metro station. The Rio Metro opened in 1979. Within 10 days, 500,000 people got on the metro. Today, there are 1 million people on the metro. It's not a very big metro. It's only about 25 kilometers, I think. But it's going to be 40. In Sao Paulo, 60% of the construction cost of the Sao Paulo Metro is returned each and every year in increased GDP to the country. That is a great investment. That is smart growth. Smart growth connects us. It creates centers of economic activity, brings us together, and improves all of our lives. If you look at the population that lives within 500 meters of a metro as a city, and you compare it to the rest, the metro-linked population is wealthier, is more educated, has better jobs, and is safer. That's why we build metros. That is why smart growth works. It is a more productive use. So smart growth for us means, first of all, having a strategy, knowing what matters, being focused, doing what you do well, not doing what you don't do well. It means planning for change, being responsive. We see in this era of evolution that city boundaries are changing. We cannot say that the city and the metropolis should be separated. We need to consider them together. We need to be responsive. It means integrating the environment. And of course, it means, perhaps most importantly, accessible to all. The city is a productivity engine. If we do not include the entire citizenry, we're simply missing an opportunity. A park. In fact, Central Park. But it's not just a park. It's a public-private partnership. It is perhaps the single most successful public-private partnership. It is currently responsible for 80% of the maintenance and operation activities of the park are funded by the Central Park Conservancy. It is an expanding park. It is now running parks in Harlem, across New York City. It is a great example of doing more with less. What should be the mandate of the city? What should be the structure of the city? That is the second thing we find cities do really well, is they do more with less, and they do so by obviously being tough on the costs, being zero-based, which is, in a city, a new idea sometimes. We often have legacy costs, and so questioning from the beginning. Exploring partnerships. What should the city be doing? What is its structure? Why should we be running these parks? Why should we be building these roads? What is the public mandate? What is the private responsibility? Creating the investment accountability. Being clear that this is a project, this is a life which goes beyond the political administration. And finally, embracing technology. Since technology has a great opportunity for making all of our services that much more responsive, whether it's predictive policing or preventive maintenance. Technology can help cities do more with less. And finally, Mayor Park. Mayor Park, who I work with, is Mayor of Seoul, currently in a re-election campaign. He likes to say he was a labor activist. He likes to say, for 20 years I stood outside of City Hall and I demonstrated against City Hall. And then on a by-election, I was brought in. And now I have to work with all these people. Well, he has what we would call a team-building challenge. Mayors win support for change. They don't stand there and project. They bring all of us into the conversation. So winning support for change means, yes, we must have a vision. We must stand for something as a mayor, as a leader of a city. But we also need to have the team. A high-quality government team is essential for a high-quality government and for a high-quality city. And that includes a culture of accountability, transparency, metrics, dialogue. Open governance is something of a new theme all around the world we see. And with that, stakeholder consensus. And pilots, whether they be the pedestrianization of Times Square or charter schools, pilots to build consensus, to try things, are the way that great mayors build that consensus. They bring the conversation into the public realm. So those are the three things that we've learned about greatness. Win support for change, do more with less, smart growth. Together, those make a great city. And I leave you with one question. How will you make your city great? I hope that we'll have many of those conversations today and tomorrow, and I look forward to having them with you. Thank you.